There were no witnesses when the first life left the water for the land. There was nobody to file a report when the first birds took to the skies. But this is one great leap that will be documented in every conceivable way. The whole world is watching. We are, after all, sending our first craft directly to the planets of another sun, the Alpha Centauri system. These are the ships that will carry our senses there. These are interstellar sailing ships propelled by light. Their hulls weigh but a gram, and they are no larger than a pea. And yet, they're equipped with all that NASA's Voyagers have, and more. First light blasts forth from this phased array of lasers, the spacecraft will accelerate from 0 to 20% of the speed of light in mere minutes. Inside each nanocraft is everything needed to perform the preliminary reconnaissance of the worlds of another star and return that visual and scientific information back to Earth. Space is mostly empty, but there are tiny dust particles that could wreak havoc if they were to collide with nanocraft traveling at such high speeds. That's one of the reasons we need to send so many of them. Voyager 1 is traveling at 38,000 miles per hour. It left home more than 40 years ago. It will take these nanocraft only 4 days to overtake her. That's pretty fast, but still only 20% of the speed of light. Proxima Centauri is 4 light years away. That's a 20-year one-way trip. Orbiting Proxima Centauri, there is a world in the habitable zone where we think life might flourish. Our robotic emissaries will send accounts from these new worlds. Their messages will race back to us on radio waves at the speed of light. They'll take 4 years to reach us. 20 years one way, 4 years back. That's a 24-year round trip. Many of you will be there then to read and to write those new pages in the book of nature and to chart our future course of wandering. Bounded by the Earth, the ocean, or the sky.